those kinds of skills, having that along with learning more about all the other topics, really provides a pretty wide, universal knowledge base for these kids. What we do in land judging is we try to get you to think about how we should use land. And those that have agricultural backgrounds kind of appreciate the idea that we grow crops in the bottom of the valley and we use pasture on the side of the hills. Of course, we're a very hilly state, and so we have to be very cognizant of how these soils respond to management. And so when it comes to cropping, we have to plant those on slopes that are less than 15%. Above 15%, pretty hard to crop, so you really should be doing some kind of permanent pasture. Or if it's really steep, 20 or 30 or 40%, you should only be growing trees on those. So what we do in land judging is we dig four separate holes so that we have four different kinds of decisions that they have to make. So there are different slopes, they might be different depths, they might have different topsoils, different permeabilities. All of those relate to how that soil should be used. And so we want to give enough variation so that the students get an appreciation for how soils vary across the landscape and how they should be used. They use their carts to measure. They have knives, they have clipboards, but all the rest of the stuff they have to have practiced with their agent on their teams to learn how to see what the slope is. So they don't have a clinometer or an ABDI level or anything like that. They have to learn how to do that by balancing their clipboard. I do not think I can overemphasize the importance of the agents and the FFA advisors. They are the ones that are in the hole with those kids night after night, a couple of hours after school, and they're working on those kids. Those kids are learning. They've memorized the book. The coaches have different ways that they've taught them to kind of shorten all the memorization. So they memorize a lot of stuff, and when they get in the hole, boy, they know exactly what to do, measure this, do that, and then they mark their cards, and it's marvelous.
Shooting a slope is definitely a skill that I didn't have. You know, you learn triangles and geometry, but this really puts it into practice for you. You get to see the different techniques that people learn, especially one thing that I know my team noticed a lot. With shooting slopes, everybody does it a different way. Texturing kind of all was the same, but it's really just cool to see everybody's different little bits of expertise come in, and you get to just observe that a little bit more. It's opened up my eyes to really what happens behind the scenes, maybe when you're building a house or when you're really evaluating your field for a farm. Biggest lesson is just learning to trust your gut in what you feel, what you see, and just really making educated guesses sometimes.
I've learned a lot on just how to be a better farmer, I guess, and understanding like how everything works for. I like the pace of it. It's slow, easygoing, and I like that a lot of it is like factual, and I like that I can put it to real world stuff. And yeah.
I'm just a really big advocate in getting youth involved in competitive agricultural events. I feel that it sparks interest among our kids, and if we can give our kids some success, then they want to continue to learn and move on to other topics. And so that's probably the key component that I see is our youth working together to accomplish a common goal.
One of the first practice pits that we did, we actually did on a guy's farm. He used our cards that we filled out because he was thinking about building a house there. So we were actually able to help our community a little bit with. It's super important to me. Agriculture is a huge piece of my life. And just to be able to actually understand what it takes to make, you know, plants and crops and even animals be successful and live to their most potential life is truly rewarding. And to be able to bring more aspects of that into the community, especially being from a smaller county, it's really nice to be able to help, you know, people in the community actually understand what they're doing and what they need to do with their land to make it to the best of its ability. So I actually really passionate about agriculture. My plan is to go into agriculture education. So this is definitely going to be one of those building blocks of how I'm able to, you know, help kids, you know, 15, 20 years from now who, you know, are in my shoes and just really kind of give back to the younger generations of kids and build their love for agriculture.
Definitely, if you have a passion for any and everything agriculture, this is like the base foundation of everything. There's so much more to it than just dirt. Like, it actually means something.